Well, that was the beginning.
And eternal.
Of a series of encounters with God mm-hmm. that nothing could explain away. The one that I really remember right now is I was doing the dishes, and I had a toddler, and of course I had all the pots and pans out, you know, for him to bang on. And we had in the other room a huge open fireplace. And I don't know how it happened. You know, as a mom, mm-hmm. it can happen so quickly. But he had gone away from me and gone into the other room, and I didn't realize what was going on, and suddenly this voice said to me, an audible voice in the room, "Daughter, see to your child." And it's like, I didn't stop to think, who's that, what's that?
Right.
It's like my spirit knew. I ran around the corner and I caught my son just before he fell into the fire. And I remember crying so much that God cared so much to rescue my son, but that he called me daughter.
Daughter.
And I think that was an amazing connection. Nobody can take that from me. There's no other explanation than that I have a father who cares about me and will come into my life and help me and touch me.
And more than that, Sue, he also has a purpose for you.
Oh, yes.
And you are really finding your purpose. Tell us about the work that you're doing now.
Oh, it's just so exciting. First of all, you know, Rhonda, I think that all the experiences that I had before, God took them and used them. Mm-hmm. So the first part of my Christian life was I was working with people who had been involved with the occult.
Right.
And what I really need people to know is that people in the New Age are wonderful people. Mm-hmm. God died for them. They're not evil people. They're people who don't know the truth. And if Jesus were walking here in the flesh, those are the people he would go to, like he spent the time with the sinners and the prostitutes. Mm-hmm. And so we need to have such a heart of love for those people. And then when he gave me my scripture, I remember reading the Bible, and Isaiah 61 jumped out at me, and I just wept. You know, he came to bind up the brokenhearted and set the captives free. And that he put into me, as he's put into you and every one of us, everything we need to do what he has put us on this planet to do. And I really know that. And I was so excited when he put in my heart to reach out to the broken and the hurting. Mm-hmm. So that's why I ended up being on the ministry team at Singing Waters in Orangeville. Right. And that the whole purpose of that is an Isaiah 61 purpose. And I learned so much from them. And then I started studying from the Elijah House and John and Paula Sanford and learning from them. And then I taught something called Freedom Fighters to reach out to help people. But then one night, God woke me up at 3:00 in the morning and he said, "I want you to write a healing manual like Looney Spoons and Crazy Plates."
And as a matter of fact, we're not infringing any copyright today because you actually phoned Janet and Greta. I've interviewed these as a secular journalist before. I've interviewed these ladies. Love their cookbook, and you asked for permission if you could mention that this was the inspiration for the book that you're working on, and they said sure. So we're not infringing any copyright here today.
No.
Have to get all the legal stuff out of the way, Sue. That's very important. But God woke you up at 3:00 in the morning.
Yes. Can you believe it?
And said,
yes, he said, write a healing manual like Looney Spoons and Crazy Plates, and each ring can be Mary.
Okay.
And I thought, okay, now I've got to check this out. First of all, it wasn't me, because I'm not going to wake up and think that. I can't see the enemy waking me up to tell me to write a healing manual, so that left God.
Right.
And then a few nights later, I had a dream where I was holding a key, and it was a skeleton key. And I didn't realize till after I asked my husband, a skeleton key opens any door.
Okay.
And I could feel it, and it was all rusty. I could smell the rust, and then suddenly it turned into gold. And he said, "There, people are locked down by the enemy. You have to give them the keys to set themselves free."
And here, this is a work in progress, but here is a manuscript that you're working on, and it is very, very user-friendly. It was important to you to write at a very basic level, grade 6, and to use little cartoony characters and keep everything very, very short. Why do you think that format is something that is so relevant?
Well, you know, when you're going through trauma, your mind is heavy with confusion. Mm-hmm. There's so many good healing books out there, but to look at one with all all those words can be daunting, overwhelming. If you're a new Canadian, if you're having trouble with the English language, if you don't understand Christianese, the Bible can be confusing. Transformed by the renewing of your mind, what's that mean? So the Lord just showed me, make it really simple, lots of pictures, and reach them. Bring my heart to my people, he said. Bring my heart to my people.
What have you learned through writing this book, this manuscript?
Well, I think what I've learned is that we need to take the truth of God and really ask him, what are you really saying to people? And boil it down to what he's really saying, and then bring it to people. And I have seen lives change. It's so marvelous. People say, I never knew this before. Nobody ever taught me this. I never understood this. And the Bible is coming alive as a truth giver. And that's what I love to see.
Well, I hope I'm not giving away any trade secrets here today, Sue, but at 100 Huntley Street, when we have a guest on the program, we ask them to provide some biographical information. We have a standard form that they can fill out. It just gives the host of the program some talking points and gives us a much more broader picture of the people that are going to be on the program. And I had to really laugh because in the 3 years that I did 100 Huntley Street previously, I don't ever recall having a guest say, you know, where it says, who is your employer? That's one of the standard questions that we ask. And your answer was God.
Can you think of a better one to work for? Like my husband always says, the pay isn't much, but the benefits are out of this world.
Well, how long have you felt that God has been your direct employer? And why is that so important for people who have felt the call of God? And I anticipate that there are people who are watching the program today who have felt that call, that spiritual call on their lives, because we are spiritual beings. We're not just in this temporal body. There is more to life than this temporal existence. And they have felt drawn. They have felt called of God. What do you say to them?
Surrender. Surrender. It's really about, like I shared with you, there's a river of God that flows. And I think what you need to do is stop waiting. Right. It's okay to splash around, but go where your feet don't touch the bottom and say, be Lord of all areas of my life. I surrender to you. I give up. And then he says, now I can use you. I can bring those gifts and talents I've put in you, and I can bring them out. And that's true for everybody. And that's what's so exciting. If 13 men can change the world, think of what we can do if we get our feet off the bottom and let God take us where we should go.
Sue Smith, thank you so much for being with us today. It's been a pleasure talking to you.